Hello and welcome! In this video, we will discover 12 mind tricks to learn faster. Did you know an hour after learning something, we forget almost half of what we learn? These are the findings of a German psychologist, Hermann Ebbinghaus, who invented the forgetting curve. According to the forgetting curve, one only remembers 30% of what they learned after 24 hours of learning. That explains why last day learning never worked for me during exams. So today, we're going to learn 12 tricks that help us learn better and faster. But just before we jump on to the 12 tricks, make sure you subscribe to the channel and don't forget to download your free book to change your life by clicking on the link in the description below the video. From now, you must learn how our brain works when it comes to strong memories. Our brain is like a hard drive with limited space. Hence, it keeps important things in memory, while discarding anything it deems unfit. It has two slots, one for temporary memory or short-term memory, and one for long-term memory. Short-term memories are things like your grocery list. The brain will remember it till you need it and discard it once you're done shopping. Long-term memories are divided into two categories, conscious memory and unconscious memory. Conscious memory includes facts such as your first phone number, your teacher's name, etc. Unconscious memories are a collection of muscle memories like your first kiss, your first concert, etc. Now that you know the basics of how the brain stores all these memories, let's get straight to the real deal. The 12 amazing tricks that are going to help you commit things to memory faster and better. 1. Building a picturesque memory. Did you know words are harder to remember on their own? However, when you link them up with a picture in your mind, not only can you learn it quickly, but retain that memory for longer, too. Let's experiment. You're going to see 10 words on your screen. See if you can remember them, preferably in the same order. Are you ready? Here we go! 1. Ice cream. 2. Bees. 3. Spoon. 4. Run. 5. Shirt. 6. Door. 7. Stop. 8. Cheese. 9. Shower. 10. Feet. Pause the video and recall all the words. Your time starts now. How many did you get? Okay, now let's do it another way. This time I'm going to show you pictures of the words. Let's see if it makes a difference in remembering. Here we go again. 1. Eggs. 2. Train. 3. Pants. 4. Tea. 5. Book. 6. Window. 7. Fruits. 8. Monkey. 9. Treehouse. 10. Skateboard. Pause the video and see how many words you remember this time. Feel the difference? Science says images are fed and stored better in the brain compared to words. Either create an imaginary storyboard or link each word to an image in your mind and you'll see the difference instantly. 2. Spaced repetition. This trick is especially for those who keep everything for the last minute, which puts almost everyone, including me, in this category. Whether you have an exam tomorrow or a speech or presentation to pitch, this trick will help you learn faster and better. Now, when we have an exam, what we usually do is keep revising all day long. Since we're continually revising, the brain doesn't find it necessary to commit this memory to the long term. It keeps it in the short-term shelves. This happens when you're learning continually without a break. Since the brain is being fed information repeatedly, it isn't getting the time to commit it to memory. And learning only occurs when you commit one thing to memory and then retrieve it. Let's say you're learning your speech, and you want to learn it better, and you want to do it quick. Here's how to go about it. Learn your speech, and now revise it. Take a short break from it for 20 minutes. Revise it again after 20 minutes. Make the next revision after 6 to 8 hours. The last and final revision should be made after 24 hours. Make sure you eat good, sleep well, and also do some light workout during the day to give your brain the right boost of energy. 3. Contact learning. Although lengthier, this process commits things far better to memory. Begin by writing out the learning material with your hands. Now read it with your eyes and speak out loud with your mouth, and make sure to hear it attentively with your ears while you read it out loud. In this method, all of your senses are consciously making an effort. The more contact you make with the material, the better and faster you'll learn. Since all five of your senses have integrated and worked to process the material into your brain will recognize it as important and keep it in the long-term memory. 4. Learn what's extremely necessary. When it comes to quick learning, one simple solution is to learn things that are the most necessary. Like a hard drive, our brain, too, has limited space. It can only commit a few things to memory and throw all the rest away. Like, if you've seen Sherlock Holmes, there's a scene where Holmes is unable to name the last three planets in our solar system. That isn't because he isn't smart enough, that's because his brain didn't think that information was relevant enough to be stored. Likewise, it's best to make compact keynotes that are easier and faster to commit to memory. 5. Read out loud. Vocal production has a huge impact on the brain. It tells the signal that this information is explicit and hence stores it in the long-term memory. Research conducted showed that a group of people was given a topic to read out loud and then were questioned. While another group was asked to read the same topic silently before being questioned, guess who did better? Surprisingly, those who read out loud not only had a better understanding of the topic, but they were quick to respond as well, while those who read silently were rather slow and were unable to commit much to memory. 6. Take notes on paper. With the advent of time, the paper is being replaced by iPads and laptops. Students prefer making notes via typing instead of using old-fashioned paper and pencil. Well, it turns out they don't help learn. Wonder why? Well, on average, a person can type as fast as the teacher speaks. Well, when you are writing on paper, that's impossible. You have to cut short sentences and kind of restructure what the teacher is saying into your own words. In this situation, your brain isn't just coping like what you would do when you were typing, but it is making a conscious effort in receiving the information, understanding the concepts, and rewriting it in your own words on paper. Not just this, when you are scribbling with a pencil, when you make an error, you have to make an effort in erasing the mistake, as opposed to when you are typing, the delete button does the job. Hence, your brain doesn't find this memory fit to keep under long-term memory. 7. The 20-minute attention span. Make the best use of the attention span you have, which in most cases lasts less than 20 minutes. You must have felt it too. You're doing some work, the first 15 to 20 minutes you're super excited and work with all the zeal, but after the 20 minutes, your attention starts to decrease and your mind begins to deviate. There comes the point where, although you may be physically doing the work, your mind is elsewhere. Research suggests that at this point, you should take a break. Do anything but work. Eat a snack, talk to a friend, do some meditation, a quick jog, anything that helps your mind become fresh. Once your mind is fresh, get back to work again. Try this method out and you'll see a vast difference. 8. Exercising is key. Did you know? Exercising daily not only aids to a fit and healthy body, but also a healthy mind. Research suggests doing high-intensity workouts helps improve your memory. It enhances the power of remembering faces, numbers, and other high-interference memories. So, next time you think about hitting the gym, just do it. 9. Do not compromise your sleep. A common practice amongst students is that they pull an all-nighter, a night before the exam, thinking this would help them ace the score, but science says otherwise. According to another research, a set of people who napped for 40 minutes after memorizing a set of cards remembered it 25% better than those who didn't. When you stay awake, your mind tires. It affects your brain's power to commit new information to memory. It also starts dumping away any short-term memory, which we in layman's terms call forgetfulness. So now you know why you feel the way you do after an all-nighter? Hence, it's essential to have a good 8 hours of sleep the night before your exam. Here's what you can do. Go through all the necessary key points before going to bed. Sleep in early for at least 8 hours. Wake up early and then revise again. 10. Teach or discuss what you are learning with others. Research carried suggests that when you teach what you are learning to others, you learn all the key points in a precise manner, which results in a better and quick understanding of the topic. Anyone who's ever taught in their lives would agree that teaching benefits both the student as well as the teacher. Likewise, discussing a topic also brings out the same results. Your mind retains a better memory of what you discuss. When you are teaching or discussing, your brain takes the task at hand differently as compared to when you were learning the material for, let's say, a test. The pressure of learning and putting it to test fades away when you're learning to teach. You make effective approaches that commit the material better and rather quicker than usual. 11. Test yourself. We all know mistakes are the building blocks of success, but did you know that our brain works more efficiently after a mistake? This means that when you make a mistake or forget what you learn and then look for the answer, your mind saves this memory, making it easier for the brain to retrieve next time it needs this particular information. Who knew learning from your mistake was this true? 12. Conditionalize the information. In other words, ditch the rote learning and instead understand why and what you are learning and why it matters so much. Facts are the hardest to learn, but it gets easier if you learn conditions under which they're most useful. Working to understand when, where, and why the knowledge is important will help to solidify the particular information in your mind. Conclusion. Just as important as these 12 tricks are for committing anything to memory faster, it is also essential that you take good care of your diet. There is no questioning the fact that what you put into your stomach affects your brain, which means the better you eat, the better the outcome of your brain. Food is the fuel that regulates your energy and mood, both of which can significantly affect your focus. While most of us stress eat, when it comes to learning, it is advised otherwise. Not because stress eating is bad, but the choice of food is what makes it worse. Would you choose to run your car on olive oil? Of course not. Then why choose the wrong foods when it comes to fueling your mind and body? Research suggests foods like blueberries, fatty fish, water, flax seeds, green tea, avocados, leafy green vegetables, dark chocolate, and nuts are great for boosting your memory and focus. Well, that's all for today. Hope you found this video informative. If you have any tricks that you swear by when it comes to increasing your learning power, let us know in the comment box below and get a chance to feature yourself. For more videos, subscribe and don't forget to click the bell icon. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, comment, and especially subscribe to the channel. You're also free to receive the new book, 7 Secrets to Change Your Life Now, by clicking on the link in the description below the video.